Today, we're talking to Stewart, the founder of a luxury photo albums business, who has created a custom integration that successfully pulls various information from all different sources directly into his team's inbox. He used AI to build it, and he's going to show us exactly how he did it. Let's get into it.
So Missive gives us a way to track conversations as well as to work as a team and deliver the best support we can. But when we're having those conversations on Missive, we don't know whether that client is subscribed to our newsletter or not, unless we go ahead, go into the CRM system, find the user, have a look. And that all takes time. And when you are a small team and perhaps there's phone calls coming into the business, emails, web chats, there's so many plates to spin. I wanted to create a quick and simple way to be able to peek inside our CRM records while the team were interacting with a client via Missive. That's why I looked into how we could integrate and create a custom integration between Missive and our CRM system.
How long do you think it took Stewart to build that first version? 10 hours. The second version that you're about to see took a single day.
So this is the integration on the right-hand side. This is just an email that I've just sent to an inbox. And along the top here, we've got some buttons, which will take us directly to that contact within the CRM system or the user within WordPress. Or here, I've added in the ability to send a Slack message into one of our Slack channels directly from the Missive integration. So we could choose a Slack channel here, send a message, and at the same time, it will add it as a note in Missive to that email. So you have that built in at the top. At the top here, we have the information from the CRM about the customer, about the client. So when did they register with us? How many times have they logged in? When did they last log in to our website? And which lists are they subscribed to? And this is the key component here. This is where we can see, are they subscribed to our newsletter or not? How many orders have they placed? The total revenue? How many days have they been a customer? And then this graph will show a distribution of orders over the past 12 months so we can get an idea of buying patterns. And then at the bottom here, we have which tags that client has and also email statistics. So this is how many newsletters they have received from us, how many they have opened, and how many clicks they have made on those newsletters. So if I just click onto this client here, you can see the integration's loading. And here we go. So now we've got some information for this client. Again, like I said, we can see the client is subscribed to the newsletter. That's great. We don't need to encourage that newsletter subscription. We can see the ordering pattern over the past 12 months. We also have the five most recent orders placed with us. Typically, a client may get in contact about a recent order. So here we can see the information immediately, and we can click on that order. And it will take us straight into WooCommerce, directly to that order, so we can review that. And then at the bottom here, we can see the number of emails they've received, how many times they've opened those emails, and how many clicks they've made. So this is the integration here.
That's pretty nice, right? I asked Stewart how he got started and the exact questions that he asked the AI agent.
I decided to have a conversation with the AI agent as perhaps I would with a software engineer. So I started by asking questions such as, are you aware of Missive? Are you aware of the Missive API? Do you know what's required to build integration with Missive? Are you familiar with Fluent CRM? What would we need to consider to integrate Missive with Fluent CRM? Should we use a WordPress plugin, or would there need to be some middleware that we'd need to build? Just have that kind of initial conversation with the AI agent and explain that this is about scoping the requirements, not building any code at this stage. I would also ask what development technology should we use? Should we be using PHP if it's going to be a WordPress plugin, JavaScript? I pointed the agent towards the Missive API documents on the website. Within those documentation, there's the Missive JavaScript that could be used to access a lot of the features within Missive. So I'd spent probably a good hour, maybe 2 hours, just having a dialogue with the agent to ensure we were singing from the same hymn sheet, in terms of what Missive is, what Fluent is, what WordPress is, how are we going to try to connect the two together? What's the ultimate goal of the integration? So we can see if the client is subscribed to the newsletter, how long have they been a client of ours? And then from there, the requirements started to broaden. Because once I got to the stage where the AI agent had built a fundamental integration, a basic integration between Missive and WordPress, now we could also start pulling information from WooCommerce. Or when was the last time the client logged into our website? We could start to bring that information in and pull it into the Missive integration.
Okay, now let's get into the technical weeds. Stewart is going to show us his cursor setup and exactly how he dialogues with the AI agent to build an extension to his existing integration.
So what you're looking at here is Cursor. So this is the AI development tool that I decided to use. On the left here, this is all of the files that the AI agent built. I would say 98% of the code has been built by the AI agent. I have gone in and I've tweaked some parts because sometimes it's easier. For example, if you want to change a color within a style sheet, it's easy to just to go in and make that change yourself rather than asking the AI agent to make a very small change to a color or something like this. But I would say 98% of the code has been written by the AI agent. In the middle here, clearly this is the code and that the AI agent creates. And then on the right here is where you interact. So what I've done here is created a prompt, which is going to be the next stage of the development for our integration. We're pulling in quite a lot of information. Something I'd like to add is the ability to view any notes which have been added to the client's record in our CRM system, and then also to add additional notes from within Missive and to push those back into the CRM system on WordPress. So what I've done here is I've started to create a prompt, and it's just like having a dialogue with, like I said, kind of software engineer. So here I've said that Fluent CRM has a concept of notes associated with contacts. These can be accessed via the Fluent CRM REST API. Here's a link to the documentation. You may be familiar with it. I'd like to show notes on the integration with a clean UI. And I'd like to know if the WordPress plugin should access notes via the Fluent CRM REST API or whether the integration should access via a different kind of method. So like having that kind of dialogue. And then here are some bullet points here. And these are specific requirements that I would like the AI to think about regarding the endpoints for the REST API, explaining that we already know the contact ID number from the email address. And then I always ask at the end here to just check in with me if it had any clarifying questions, and also do not make any code changes at this stage. And then we would send this to the AI agent. And hopefully it'd be fairly quick here. It'll then come back to me with some responses and it will ask some follow-up questions. So the agent, here we go, let's have a look. So the agent says it's going to analyze the requirements and ask some clarifying questions. First, let me understand the current authentication setup. Based on my analysis of the code base and your requirements, I have some clarifying questions. So now you're going to ask me, how would we like the authentication flow to be created? And it says, I see the plugin currently uses a security system with API keys. Would you prefer to store the Fluent CRM REST API credentials username key in the same way? So and so forth. What I would do is I'd review these questions from the agent and I'd respond to it. And we'd go through an iterative process. And then finally, I'll get to the stage where I'd be happy. And then I would say, okay, go ahead, build this feature.
It's kind of an unbelievable time to be alive. Super practical custom software is available to so many small businesses in just hours or days. If you're interested in building your own custom integration, or even if you have one to show off, let us know in the comments below, and we'll see you in the next one.